many stories out there about good versus evil, the light versus the dark, yin against yang. For this story, we have to go back to June of 2016. It's a good time at Eastchester High School. The students are finishing up their exams, the teachers are making plans for their summer, and the high school is saying goodbye to their beloved AP, Chris Fiore, who's taken a job as principal at another high school.
So how'd you do?
Best I could. Sorry for taking so long and being the last one.
Don't worry about it. I'm sure you did fine.
Thanks. Well, I guess you're just as happy as the rest of us. The school year's over. You don't have to deal with any more students.
It's funny you say that. I'm actually a little sad. Helping you guys achieve is what I love in life. And not having that for the next 2 months, it's going to be a little depressing.
Well, have a good summer.
At peace with no sound of students, no whines and complaints for another year. The school fills my heart when there are no students. My mind can't pretend they were never I won't have to tell them not to text neath their desks or their parents why they got a C. My brain just can't take one more lame excuse. Oh, look, a birdie.
That is horse crap.
You gonna eat that?
You've got mail.
What's this email from the state? Increase your scores in reading and math and get more funding for your district. I've already maximized the scores in the middle school. But if I maximize the scores in the high school, I can be the King Golden Child and ruler of the district!
I never thought high school teachers essential. They're crude and unspeakably plain. But maybe there's a glimmer of potential. Give a line to my vision and brain. I know your powers of instruction are as weak as a pass in gym class. But thick as you are, pay attention. My words are a matter of pride. It's clear from your overall test scores. The louts do not all seem to care. But we're talking funds and vast rewards. So our kids achieve grades beyond compare. Be prepared to test and assess them. Be prepared for a amazing reviews. A shining new era is tiptoeing nearer. Just listen to teacher. I know it sounds sordid, but you'll be rewarded when at last I have given my dues and our outcomes diligently squared. Be prepared.
But I need somebody on the inside. Who can I get? The high school AP position is open. But what teacher can I get that will have the least impact on student test scores?
Well, what I'm saying is that Boba Fett escaped the Sarlacc pit.
They only did that for, like, no reason. People liked Boba Fett. He didn't say anything. He never did anything. He was a lackey of the Empire, and yet some reason people think he is, like, the coolest character in the universe. And I just never understood why.
First of all, Boba Fett is not a lackey of the Empire. He's an independent contractor working in a universe that's so vast. And if you got a military contract, you'd take it too.
Second, he's got the backpack. He's got the grappling hook.
Same crap with Batman. Everybody's like, oh, Batman is so much better. He's got all the gadgets. He could just do whatever. He could beat Superman. I don't think so. Anybody with super speed will kill Batman in a second. It's the same thing with Boba Fett. Well, he's done. You get the Force, you rip the suit off him, he's over.
Thereby, your philosophy, you're saying that Boba Fett is the Batman of the Star Wars universe.
Yeah, and just as useless. It must be really nice to have this be your curriculum. You just get to sit around with your students and talk about this nonsense all day.
What are you talking about? I'll have you know we're watching an iconic film today that was paramount in allowing the male population to become less chauvinistic in society. In addition, we'll also be discussing the feminization of Sylvester Stallone.
You're watching Tango and Cash.
Hey man, it's not what you watch, it's why we watch it. I'll have you know, next week we're watching a film that teaches how to add suspense and anxiety into the audience. Okay? It's a movie about this guy whose wife is brutally murdered by a serial killer. And during that event, his son is left physically disabled.
Oh.
I know. And that's not all. In a twisted turn of events, his son gets kidnapped, and the father has to chase the son across thousands of miles to get his son back. And all he has the help of a mentally handicapped friend.
That sounds really interesting. What's it called?
Finding Nemo.
You're an idiot.
Hey man, don't hate the director. Hate the game.
All right, I'm gonna go do some real work. I got some labs to grade. I'll see you later.
Hello? Yeah, here. I'm Miss School Principal. Okay, I'm on my way.
Mr. Goldstein.
Hey, Mr. Wayne.
Thanks so much for coming down.
Yeah, no problem at all.
Please, close the door. Have a seat.
Sure.
So, would you like to play a game?
Sir?
Oh, your shirt. It's a saying from War Games with Matthew Broderick.
Very much, yes.
Let's get down to business. Here in Eastchester, we like nothing more than academic achievement. In order to demonstrate that, we have assessments. Things that, you know, like data and scores that show student achievement and teacher effectiveness. Help us show that our students are, I would just say, studious.
Okay.
You know, unfortunately, in order to have that, we've had to shift some funding around, you know, away from the arts, which could have an effect on your position and your program.
How's this possible?
I know, it's unfair. I myself have tried to let the district go in a different direction. It would be a shame to lose you.
There's gotta be something we can do.
Perhaps. You know, there is an AP position open at the high school. Maybe if you showed a little initiative, I could put in a good word for you.
Assistant principalship, administration, I don't think that's really me.
what is your favorite Matthew Broderick film?
Oh, well, of course I like War Games. Then there's Glory and The Freshman and...
The Producers?
No, The Producers, not. Musicals suck. I hate musicals. But there's Lady Hawk, there's Family Business, Project X, there's this one with this... You ever see that one? It's got like this... Matthew Broderick's a pilot and he's grounded by the Air Force, but they make him teach monkeys to fly, and there's this cute little monkey in there named Virgil.
Ferris Bueller's Day Off! That's your favorite Matthew Broderick film!
Okay, yeah, Ferris. I like Ferris Bueller's. John Hughes, good. I like it, yeah.
You know, in that film, everybody thinks that Ferris Bueller is the hero. They love him. They think he's young and fun and energetic. But the real hero of that film is the one who takes control. Edward Rooney.
Isn't Rooney the villain in the movie? I mean, doesn't his day get progressively worse as he chases Ferris around?
It's only because he got emotional. You know, everybody's got to grow up at some time. Everybody needs to be a little more like Edward Rooney and take control.
Yeah, but I don't have my administration license.
Oh, there's nothing to it. Honestly, you can delegate things to people when you don't understand them. Or you can schedule meetings to make yourself seem more busy, and then you can cancel them. You know, honestly, there are winners sometimes, and there are losers sometimes. When it comes down to it, Mr. Goldstein, it's really how you play the game.
All right, I'll do it.
Excellent. I need you to go to the math department meeting. I need you to let them know that we will give them anything they need in order to be successful.
Okay, you got it.
Mr. Goldstein, wear a suit.
I'm singing in the lab, just singing in the lab. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. I'm laughing at flasks so filled with acid. Fusion's in my heart and I'm ready for art. Dancing in the lab.
So you see, the math department will have the full support of the district in the coming year. Anything you need, the district will give you guys.
And we need more pencils and papers and other supplies.
I think the supplies have already been ordered for next year. I don't know.
But arts is losing funding. The district supports us.
Yeah, let's go take the arts teacher supplies. We need them more than they do.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's go.
All right.
Let's do it.
Let's get them.
No, no, please, guys, please. No. I think what we got to do is calm down and think about this and, oh boy, this isn't going to be good.
Thank you.
Mr. Mesmer.
You mean Mr. Robinson?
Oh, sorry. The math department's coming to take your supplies.
Oh, no, we gotta stop them. Miss Sid, Mr. Perry. Looks like I'm all alone. And I can't stop them by myself. Yes, we can. We have enough personalities to do this.
Let's just get out of here.
Shut up. We're doing this.
We're doing this.
Math is gonna have their way tonight.
The arts are gonna have our ways denied.
Arty teachers cheating with grades, 'cause when they calculate data, it's opinion based.
They're gonna take our supplies tonight.
We're gonna extrapolate them out tonight.
We said okay to paper, no pens, but just in case they take them, we're ready to mix tonight. We're gonna rock it tonight. We're gonna jazz it up and have us a ball. They're gonna get it tonight. The more they turn it on, the harder they fall.
Will they produce it?
Will they begin it? And we're the ones to stop them once and for all tonight.
To control them. What's it gonna be, Goldstein? Tenure and test scores? Or unemployment?
I know what you're thinking, has goals even dreaming? This school is super hot. Other grades should matter, but without our kids are sadder, 'cause there's one thing you forgot. To score an A would be just fine. I'd rather any kid of mine learn the greatest kind of skill. Thrills me like a film. Picture a world where all the boys and girls have a place in the film fest. That freckled face sophomore drawn a storyboard that Jock who trades in his pen dress. That short guy standing on a box that's marking writing up their clock. That lunch lady who's kind of shrill. Nothing thrills me like a film. G-rated R. Wars on tracks in the stars. A long chase in the car makes Steve McQueen the coolest. Don Corleone wears black after Sonny gets whacked. All on the silver screen.
Oh, really? Then answer these questions, if you please. What would you do if you had to choose between your films and this idol of gold?
Films.
What would you say if you gave the fest away? In return, you'd never grow old.
Films.
Would you prefer to get tenure or have your own bat suit?
It's moot.
What if rupees were within your reach?
I'm gonna stop you right there. It's films. Come on, Gandhi. Get your head out of your tuchus.
2, 3, 4! Scores will come and scores will go, but there's only one absolute. When you go to a show, then you know there's no accepted substitutes. I'm sorry, Scott, let's not pretend. Without the arts, where will it end? You can cut the arts, but then someday soon, these kids aren't going.
Wait for it. But you know, I really could use tenure.
I choose you, Mr. Wynn.
So there you have it. Compromise is key. You can't have good without evil. The dark needs the light. And yin, well, you get it.
My school.
And sometimes, it's just about good old-fashioned vengeance.